On this day, October 16, 1820, circulates the newspaper founded by José Cecilio del Valle, El Amigo de la Patria. On October 16, 1820, on Friday, circulated in the streets of Guatemala City, the newspaper El Amigo de la Patria, which the prominent Honduran José Cecilio del Valle founded in order to fight for the cause of Central American independence. The newspaper in reference appeared after El Editor Constitucional, founded by Dr. Pedro Molina, and also appeared in the Guatemala metropolis on Monday, July 24, 1820. Both newspapers emerged on the podium of the press expressing the will for the independence. As a result of the promulgation of the Spanish Constitution of 1812, that Ferdinand VII was forced to do as a consequence of the revolution led by General Rafael de Riego. In the first issue of El Amigo de la Patria, and on its front page appeared the article entitled Sciences, which has since been produced abundantly under the title of The Wise. Such work begins with the famous apothegm of the author of the Act of Independence, which literally says, "On the scale of beings, man is first. On the scale of men, the sage is the greatest." The political theory expounded by El Amigo de la Patria and El Editor Constitucional, although similar in terms of the purposes pursued, had many differences in terms of the means to be used to achieve independence. The first was a moderate newspaper that aspired to be a gradual independence achieved in accordance with the evolution experienced by the peoples. The second censored the defects of the colonial administration, made open campaigns in favor of independence, and advocate a rapid action to achieve it. Around El Amigo de la Patria was constituted the Gasista Party, or Bacchus Conservative, constituted by Peninsular Spaniard, the rich, the elements belonging to the artistic spheres, and the craft. In the shadow of El Editor Constitucional was formed the party of the Cacos, liberal, composed of the nobles and the elements in favor of independence. Both tendencies would have expression at the time of the proclamation of independence, when the annexation to Mexico was made and when the first federal executive was elected. Their struggle resulted in the failure of federal unity and the disaster of the years immediately following. This was a day in the history of Honduras.